Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa nu'minu bihi wa natawakkalu alayhi wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فقد قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم والله غفور رحيم وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من والده وولده والناس أجمعين أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام صدق الله العظيم. Alhamdulillah, my dear respected brothers and sisters, it is a great blessing and a mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has given us the tawfiq and He has given us the ability to see another day of Yawm al-Jum'ah. My dear respected brothers and sisters, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we praise Him and we glorify Him for giving us this chance, for giving us this opportunity, one more day, one more hour, one more minute, so we can turn back to Him, we can repent to Him, and we can change our lives and worship Him. My dear respected brothers and sisters, the ayah that I have recited, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentions one thing and He says, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ, talking to the believers, talking to the people, He says, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ, that, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell them, tell the people, إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ, that if you claim to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you claim to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَاتَّبِعُونِي, then follow me. Meaning follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يُحِبُّكُمْ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرُ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. And what will happen when that happens? When you follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what is going to happen? That you don't have to worry about you loving Allah. Allah Himself says, يُحِبُّكُمْ اللَّهُ, that I, Allah, will love you. يُحِبُّكُمْ اللَّهُ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will love you. وَيَغْفِرُ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ, and He will forgive your sins. So we find that in following the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says that if you follow His way, if you follow His footsteps, then I, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will love you. I, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, love you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in many places in the Quran, you'll find about following the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when He says, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةً حَسَنَةً لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرُجُ اللَّهِ لِمَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهُ الْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. In different places, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says that indeed, in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there's an example. For those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for those who hope for the hereafter, for those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who wishes to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who wishes to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For them, there is an example in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, meaning that we are encouraged to follow the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If we want to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while He is happy with us, if we want to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while He is glad with us and He is pleased with us, then our only way is to follow the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because every action that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved it. And He loved it so much that He said that anybody that follows Him, not only Him, anybody that follows Him, whatever He did, however He did it, if you do the same thing in the same manner, in the same way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you also. My dear respected brothers and sisters, the question comes, that how much are we following the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? How much do we look up to him? Many times we are so much offended when somebody says something against the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You see a person draw a cartoon, he will write something, and he will say something against the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, slandering him, his honor. And you will see the Muslims and the Muslim Ummah just get so angry. Protests on the street. So angry that how can you say such a thing against the Prophet ﷺ? And this reaction is normal. This reaction is understandable. But the thing that does not make sense, the part that does not make sense, is when we get so angry, but we ourselves, we are not following the Prophet ﷺ. These people, when they say something against the Prophet, when they write something against the Prophet, when they try and they try to make fun of the Prophet ﷺ, they ridicule the Prophet ﷺ, they don't know. They have no idea who he was. They don't know him. They have no idea what he has done, what he has sacrificed, what he has given up. But we as Muslims, we as the people that claim Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the final messenger, we that claim Muhammad is the final messenger and he is the most beloved to us, we get so angry. But in reality, when we look at our lives, we are not following the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There is no sign of sunnah. Our akhlaq is far from the akhlaq of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Our way of life is far from his way. Yet we are angry with them. What about us? What are we doing? Every single day we are sacrificing the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ so we can follow the other style. Whether it comes to how you dress, whether it comes to your akhlaq, how you deal with the people, how you deal with the Muslims, how you deal with the non-Muslims, every single aspect, every single time, every single step, we are going against the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. And then we are getting angry. It doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense. We have no sunnah in our lives. We look at our community, we look at the youth. When they are growing up, they don't look at the Prophet ﷺ as a role model. They look at athletes, they look at actors, they look at singers. They want to be like them. And again, the fault is coming to us because we did not do anything. We did not guide them. We are not showing them the way. The only thing we're doing, we are judging them and we're judging them. But when we look at the ummah, that we are looking and we look up to other people. Our style, we follow the style of other people. We follow the way of the West. But when it comes to the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, we make excuses. We make excuses. One sunnah, it is so valuable. Today we don't understand, but the Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'in, they understood the value of sunnah. Today when somebody says that this is sunnah, then we look at him and says, oh, it is only sunnah. That is only sunnah. And we degrade the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ by saying these things. But the Sahaba, they loved the Prophet ﷺ so much. They followed him every step of the way. Everything that he did. They followed him. We come to one example when one of the Sahaba, he was invited by the Persian emperor. He was invited in the gathering of the Persian emperor to have dinner with them or to have a meal with them and to discuss some of the things while they were in battle with the Persian emperor. He invited some of the Sahaba that come, sit down and have a meal with me and we'll discuss some things. So one of the Sahaba, he was sent on behalf of the Muslim Ummah. On behalf of the Muslim army, he was sent. So he entered the gathering of who? The Persian emperor. The Persian emperor, one of the strongest person at that time. So he entered his gathering. And they sat down and they talked and they had the meal. And while they were eating, the Sahabi, he was eating and he dropped a morsel of food. He dropped some food onto the floor. Or onto the spread that they had spread out. So what does he do? He looks at the food and he remembers the saying of the Prophet ﷺ. And he remembers the advice of the Prophet ﷺ when he says that if something falls, then pick it up, blow on it and eat it. So he picks up the food, he blows on it and he eats it. So one of the servants that was there, or one of the people that was there, he looked at the Sahaba and he says, oh, you shouldn't have done that. He says, you shouldn't have done that. Why? Because now you look like a poor person. You look like a beggar. that every single drop of food, morsel of food that is falls to the ground, you have to pick it up and eat it. It just shows that you're poor, you have no food, you're starving all the time. You know, you should have thought about it, because you're sitting in front of the who? You're sitting in front of who? Not some random person, but you're sitting in front of the king, the emperor of Persia. You're sitting in this place and you pick up the food from the ground. It doesn't look good. It didn't look good. So the Sahaba, he got mad upon hearing this. He got mad upon hearing this. And he tells the person that, should I sacrifice the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Should I sacrifice the sunnah of my beloved for this fool? And he's sitting in front of the king. He says, should I sacrifice the sunnah of my beloved Muhammad al-Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam for these people? He says, never. How can I sacrifice the sunnah for these people? Today we are sacrificing the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam every single day. It's so easy for us to look over the sunnah. Yet when we look at the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when we look at the lives of the Sahaba, how much they held on to the sunnah. They would not let it go. They would not go against it. Some of them were even more strict when it comes to the life of Umar radiallahu anhu. He was so strict upon following the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that in his lifetime, what did he see? He saw that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam lived, and he lived a simple life. He lived a simple life. Upon occasion, he came to the house of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he saw him laying against this sack. And he saw that this, when he was laying against, it made marks on his back. And he claimed, "Ya Rasulullah, O Prophet of Allah, you are the messenger of Allah. If you want, you can have anything." He says, the Persian emperor and the Roman emperors, they have so much wealth. They have so much comfort. And then you, being the messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you're living in this situation. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he advised him and he said something to the effect. He told him that this is not our life. This is not our life. The worldly life is not our life. It is only temporarily. And he saw this. He witnessed the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It comes at 3 days. 3 days will go by, and there will be no fire lit in the house of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Simple life he led. Umar radiallahu anhu, he saw this at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he held on to this. They're living a simple life. Living a simple life. So what happened? The life of Abu Bakr, the Khilafah Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu came. He was there and he witnessed how Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu led a simple life. So now came his turn, and now he was Khalifa. And under his Khilafah, when he was Khalifa, under his rule, the Muslims conquered lands. And he became one of the most powerful men on earth. One of the most powerful men on earth. The Roman Empire and the Persian Empire, the two top emperors at that time, they fell. All the wealth was brought to Medina. All the wealth was brought to Medina. Yet Umar radiallahu anhu did not take anything from it. He did not take anything from it. Neither did he change his way. Neither did he change his lifestyle. Neither did he change the way that he saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam living his life. Upon occasion, it comes that Umar radiallahu anhu, some of the Sahabas, they came together and they approached. They came together and they had a meeting and they wanted to approach Umar radiallahu anhu to change his way, his lifestyle, that he's so simple. He lives such a simple life. He wears a thawb, but the thawb is made out of thick material. Thick material. Not only that, this thawb has patches everywhere. His clothes got torn. What did he do? He patched it up. He did not buy a new one. He did not go to a store and just, get a new one. There's nothing wrong with it, but it was his way. It was the way he saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi living. The Sahaba, they gathered. They said that we need to approach Umar radiallahu anhu about this. the delegations from other countries, people from other countries, they come and they see the Muslim Ummah. They know that the Muslim, they know about Umar radiallahu anh. They know about the Muslim empire. So when they come to see Umar radiallahu anh in this state, it doesn't look good. So they approached, they came up with this plan, but they were afraid to approach Umar radiallahu anh. He said, how can we approach him? He's very strict. So they went to the mother of the believers, Hazrat Aisha radiallahu anha, and they asked her, that can you approach Umar radiallahu anh? Can you talk to him? That maybe he might change his clothes a little bit. Maybe when the other people come and they come to sit down with him, and maybe share a meal with him, what does he eat? He eats dry bread. He eats bread, only bread, and it is so hard, you have to dip it in water or something else for it to actually soften up. This is his meal. So can you talk to him? Again, this is the way he lived his life. He was the king. If he wanted, he could have had everything. But he saw the Prophet ﷺ. He saw how he led his life. So when Hazrat Aisha radiallahu anha, she approached Umar radiallahu anha, and she said, oh Umar, oh Amir al-Mu'mineen, that this is a request some of the Sahabas made. That if you can change maybe your way of life a little bit, just change your clothing a little bit, wear something better quality, you know, eat better food. Umar radiallahu anhu, he says, never. He said, how can I change the way? How can I change my lifestyle? When I saw Rasulullah s.a.w. living like this, when I saw Rasulullah s.a.w., the days would go by and he had no food. Days would go by and he had no food. And food used to come and he used to eat dry dates and water. This is the way he led his life. And he says, how can I change? How can I go away from that? Even though he had all the wealth, if he wanted, he could have just asked. And they would have made him a robe. They would have made him a crown. They would have made him everything. But Umar radiallahu anhu, he did not ask for any of that. Because he stuck to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he claimed, and the Sahaba, they were those people that they loved the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Today, we claim and we say we love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but in our lives, we have no sunnah. In our dealings with people, we have no sunnah. It is missing. The way the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam dealt with other people, even though he was abused by them, he was hated by them, but never once did he show hatred. The people of Mecca in the early days, what did they do? They did everything to harm the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam possible, to harm the Sahaba. But what did he do? The sunnah of the Prophet, the way that he led his life, what did he do? He showed kindness. He showed mercy to the people. He showed mercy to the people. This is a quality that is missing. The qualities of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Sahaba, they had these qualities, and what happened? We saw that the Muslim empire expanded. There was a lot of Muslim, hundreds and thousands of people accepted Islam. Today we lead such lives that no one wants to accept Islam by looking at us. They'll go and read the Quran and they'll find about Islam and then they want to accept Islam. But if somebody was to look at us, they're not ready to accept Islam. Because the way we deal with everything, Muslims are cheating in their businesses. They are lying. They are not fulfilling the rights of other people, of their neighbors, of their parents, of their children, of the Muslims, of the non-Muslims, everybody. People look at us and they don't want to be Muslims. People looked at the Sahaba because what? They followed the Sunnah. They looked at the Sahaba and they wanted to become Muslim. They looked at the Sahaba and they changed their culture and they started following whatever the Sahabas did. They looked at the Sahaba. They saw how beautiful the Sunnah was. They changed their language. Whatever they spoke, they changed it to Arabic. They changed their culture to the culture of the Sahaba, meaning the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They saw it, and it played a big impact. It played a big part. That what character Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had. People are abusing him. They are cursing at him daily. They spat on his face. But yet, every day he showed them a smile. Every day he went and he worried about the hereafter. He worried about them. He was concerned about them. Yet these same people, they hated him. They despised him. They abused him. Yet he showed them kindness. Today somebody abuses us, the first thing we do is abuse them back. Somebody hits us, the first thing we do is hit them back. Somebody curses at us, the first thing we do is curse them back. Curse back at them. Where is the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ? When the people of Makkah, they abused him, they cursed at him, he did not say a single word. His own uncle, his own flesh and blood stood up and cursed the Prophet ﷺ. Abu Lahab. Yet he did not curse him back. His enemies, they're amazed at what kind of person this is. Whatever you do, he shows kindness, he shows mercy upon mercy. People pelted him with stones. From head to toe he was bleeding. On the day of Ta'if. Yet what does he do? He comes out from the city, he raises his hands, and he makes dua. And he forgives them. The angel is ready. Ya Rasulullah, give me the order, I will destroy this city. Ya Rasulullah, give me the order, I'll let these mountains crumble upon these people of the city. They abused you. Yet the Prophet ﷺ, he says, no. No, he showed them kindness when they showed him hate. That was his sunnah. That was his way. And this is exactly what we must follow. This is what we must do. Follow his way. Follow his akhlaq. Bring those characteristics in our lives. Today, many times when we go out, people hate on us. Day in day, it is getting worse. But what must we do? Show them kindness. Show them the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. Show them who the Prophet ﷺ was. Who he was. How loving he was, how caring he was, how forgiving he was. Be an example. Today we are so busy with our lives. We are so busy with this dunya, we forget about all this. The only thing that we are concerned about is making money. The only thing that comes in our mind is making money. How can we get a better position in this world? But no, my dear respected brothers and sisters, we must follow the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. We must follow his footsteps. Follow his way of life. Show the people in this country, not only in this country, around the world, what it means to be a Muslim, what it means to be a follower of the Prophet ﷺ. Who the Prophet ﷺ, who Muhammad ﷺ truly was. Show the people through your actions, through our actions, through our behavior. Sometimes we only look at, oh, this person doesn't have a beard, oh, astaghfirullah. Oh, this person is not dressing sunnah, astaghfirullah. He's not following the sunnah. But we have the beards, we have everything. But then in our daily lives, there's no sunnah. It's just appearance. It doesn't go like that. Both ways. Follow him the way he looked. Follow the way he walked. Follow the way he talked. Follow the way he sat down and ate. He went to sleep. Everything from the time we get up to the time we go to sleep, there is a way that the Prophet ﷺ did these things. As Muslims, we must follow him in every footstep. And when we do that, what happens? When we do that, what happens? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declares in the Quran, يُحِبِبُكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرُ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Allah will love us. Allah will love us and he'll forgive our sins. What happens when Allah loves us? If Allah was to love us, if Allah was to become pleased with us, what happens? We have no worry. وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. There is nothing to worry about. If Allah is to be pleased with us, if Allah is to love us, if Allah is to forgive our sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to bring his characteristics into our lives. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of our sins. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. Couple minutes for sunnah, inshallah.